or is it too risky? Like, what are things that we can do as everyone within the architecture profession to make more money, be more profitable, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I think, yeah, real estate is very risky. I once had a very, very well-known real estate developer tell me, "You're not really a developer until you've gone bankrupt twice." So, you
it's
know,
hardcore.
It's hardcore.
And I'm sure he meant it.
He did mean it.
Yeah.
And, you know, so it is a very, very tough game. And I think that there are many architects who are not suited to taking on that kind of risk. But I do think that what's important is explaining your value, communicating your value to the project. So it's, you know, I think it's very silly that we sell our time by the hour. We sell our intelligence or our creativity by the hour, right? Because, you know, if you're $500 an hour or $1,000 an hour, or whatever your time is, right? Like, probably a lot of hours are worth about $30. And then some hours are worth $30 million.
Yeah.
And so it's a kind of crazy thing. Could you imagine if we paid musicians, like pop stars, by the hour?
Right.
Like, oh, you know, whoever, Taylor Swift, you know, we'll pay you $1,000 per hour that you wrote that hit song. It's the most ridiculous thing ever. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think that that's a negative way, not a great business model. So I think that what we have to do is we have to explain that by being a very skilled architect, you're creating long-term value to the project, you know? And that's not just the rents that it gets the day it opens, or the university, you know, attracting more students to apply to that university, or, you know, advising a pro team to change their uniforms to match the building so that their sales of uniforms go, you know, sales of t-shirts goes up.
Right.
Like it's also what's the long-term cost of owning and operating the building. Like we figured out a way to use a higher quality material that you're not going to have to maintain as much over the next 20 years, but we figured out a way to use that source, fabricate, assemble, and use that material where it didn't cost you any extra today, but it's going to save you $500,000 every 5 years in maintenance costs.
Right.
Well, that's a huge amount of money. And how do we need to be able to communicate how to be paid for those kinds of values.
Gotcha.
And that's a hard thing to explain because, yeah, there's a reason they want to pay us by the hour because it's cheap. Or a flat fee or whatever it might be.
Yeah,
so
right.
it's that to me is the rub in how we have to sort of rethink the profession to be in that way. And so the fastest way to get into that position is by investing in the projects, because then you're sort of on both sides of the equation. But that's a lot of risk.